Biscuits and tea.
Okay. I don't know if this is, if you can give an answer to this, but so Will, if Will was going to be selected by one of these organizations, CIA, Navy, like, where do you think he would fit? He can speak 8 languages fluently. He's extremely fit. He doesn't eat sugar. He's up every day, meditates. He's one of the most focused people I've ever met my entire life. Like, where do you think he could be best utilized if USA needed him tomorrow?
I mean, those skills could be applied. I mean, any. I mean, you can't replicate ability to maneuver between different communities fluidly with language ability, right? That takes a lifetime, and even if they had all the training, they still couldn't get those capacities. So. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Will, you're a hot commodity with that.
There we go.
You know? Nobody would suspect you up in Russia speaking Russian as an American informant.
I know. Yeah, that does always throw the Eastern languages or Eastern European languages always throw people when they see black guys that are coming out.
Funniest
it
things.
Never.
You should tell
is
that
it
story.
Not always hilarious.
You should tell that story about Zach Neese in Kansas.
Oh God! All right. Well, so what happened is that Brandon, we were filming the 21-day challenge.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Is that during that time? Mm-hmm. So we were filming, this 21-day challenge. You know, just something cool for everybody to be able to train. And we were at the field, and it's not a public field, but it acts as a public field. It's essentially, you know, these massive parks that they're building now. There's like nearly 15, maybe 10, maybe more fields at this place. No one's using them. It's the middle of the day. Right. It's the summer, obviously, and we're off. And so we went out there to film, and we're filming. We had, I think, a tripod set up and something, and we see out of the corner of my eye while we were actually filming. It's like a movie. A little guy in a little golf cart comes, zzz, you know how they look, they move all weird and funny. A guy, and he had a little hat, and he's probably in his late 50s or early 60s, something like that, right?
Really?
He's overweight. He's not looking the best, et cetera. And he just, instead of, you know, kind of diffusing the situation, which would have been the best thing to just say at least hello, right? B? Right. Maybe just,
Hey, how you guys doing?
something. He zoomed up into this golf cart, and he basically like stopped it, but like he like hopped off at the same time.
He was, in front of the camera.
Dismount.
He stopped. He pulled in front of the camera, stopped, and then walked towards the camera while he's on set.
And he goes, "You guys can't be here, you know." And you can't. And still, we were still very calm. We were very shocked, also too, because it was kind of like, "What exactly are we doing? That's so bad." And we went back and forth. It was actually really ridiculous, all the things that he was trying to say, that the governor, he's going to call the governor or somebody on him. We didn't know. He was just trying to up us, you know. We're right. Like, we know everybody here. We're friends with all the people. It's not a big deal. Like, if we can't be here, do you mind if we just finish what we're doing and then we'll go? He kept escalating the situation to the point that we were getting frustrated. And so we kind of start making fun of him and kind of poking at him. I don't know what brought up languages be. Do you remember?
He was acting like he didn't understand.
Do you understand
English.
Me? Do I need to say another language? Oh, I can say it in Russian.
And then we just kind of said fine. And then he said, and he's not that this accent is not from Kansas. I don't know where the guy's from, but he did say it like Zat Knees. He said Zat Knees, which the word is Zat Knees, which is the Russian word for shut up. And of course, said it to him, and then started speaking to him in Russian, of which he knew and understood nothing. So he, like a party trick, he learned one Russian word that he was going to throw out on the black guy in Kansas, which should normally work. You know, but no.
One of the funniest things I've ever seen, that guy's face when Will just started speaking, he just rattled out like 4 or 5 sentences at him, and he was like, what, Zach Neese?
What are the chances?
I don't know where I would go. I honestly, because I do like to spend, I'm an only child, and I grew up, my parents are obviously incredibly involved in my life. Not having any brothers or sisters, I learned to have a love for spending time alone. And so that leads to meditation, that leads to self-study, that leads to self-improvement, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
That's awesome.
You know? And so the reason I asked my friend about snipers is because they also have to spend a whole lot of time alone. Yeah. And they've been known to enter into the flow state. They have to watch their breath, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It takes a different type. But he told me those guys are really weird. I don't know. Do you guys have a version of goalies in the Navy? Because the goalies in soccer are clearly, they're not normal, like not even close, you know? So like, do you guys have a, or is, do the armed forces have a, like, you guys are weird.
No, I mean, yeah, for sure. And so, you know, I'm not a submariner, but anybody who would go inside a tin tube,
goalies,
time, right? It's a little bit different.
Tyler.
So, I mean, but it, I mean, it's a, anytime you get in those small communities, it's also sort of, you know, an elite status as well. So to be weird is to be good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, in some ways.
Okay.
So make you feel good.
Well, that's cool.
So make you feel better. You're part of an elite community.
No, I would never. I'd be terrified of going to something.
Yeah, it makes two of us. I'm not a huge fan.
How deep can those go?
Well, I guess that's probably classified, right?
So, exactly. I was just going to say that officially or
no, it's